name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus tells us in the Gospel that he is the true vine, and we are the branches. And we proclaim our love for Jesus, and our love for God, and our following him by obeying his commandments, by our love for one another. We pray during this Mass that we will have the grace to remain in him by living a life of love. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us now call to mind our sins.
I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may, under your protective care, bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people.
I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly.
soul shall live, my descendants shall serve. Let the coming generations be told of the Lord, that they may proclaim to their people, yet to be born, the justice he has shown.
How great is the Lord in the assembly of your people.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Children, let us love, not in words of speech, but in deed and truth. Now this is how we shall know that we belong to the truth. We assure our hearts before him, and whatever our hearts condemn. For God is greater than our hearts, and knows everything. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have confidence in God. We receive from him whatever we ask, because we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. His commandment is this: we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another just as he commanded us. Those who keep his commandments remain in him, and he in them. And the way we know that he remains in us is from the Spirit he gave us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Stone. trusting as such until Barnabas stood by Paul. We've all had that occasion when we need someone to stand up with us so that we can be accepted. We've gone into places where we don't know anyone, but someone comes up and says, yes, I know you. Very helpful. Paul proclaims the good news all over Jerusalem until the Hellenists try to kill him. They don't want to hear what he has to say. The apostles then send Paul on to talk. Getting out of that. But no matter what they did with that, the church still grew. And the Hellenists and the other opposition could not hinder its growth. Our second reading is kind of like, hear this, pay attention to it. Love, not with words, but in deeds and action and truth. We do a lot of talking, don't do anything. Just the opposite. We're Catholic, we're Christians. We confirm to follow our Lord Jesus Christ. Really? Well, it's simple. Love each other. Love all the things that God has given us. Don't kill his creatures for fun. Don't destroy the home he has given us, earth, for profit. Don't take what's not yours. There is no master but God. That's what gives us a purpose to follow our Lord Jesus Christ. The purpose is our salvation. Not what's here on earth, what's in heaven. We seem to sometimes get all involved in what's going on here. But can we get out of it and lose sight of heaven and our salvation and who leads us? We have all sorts of leaders, but there is no one more deserving. Not here. And the Father Christ. He reminds us that we think we're so better than anyone else, that the first will be last. We have a problem. It's a warning. There is purpose. The gospel tells us, because without me, you can do nothing. That will impress you if you don't do it for me. We've known that when we grew up as children. Keep in mind, we're always called children. To impress my mother and my father, I had to do something to impress them. But I did it out of love. Without me, you can do nothing. This is where I'm going to come in with this. Hold on for a moment. There were 10 plagues. Pharaoh paid no attention. They got worse and worse and worse and worse. Well, could someone use climate change for that? It's man-made. Or does it come from God? Who warns us with fires and drought, melting ice caps? All sorts of things are warnings to us. I remember after 9/11, the news were full. Climate change has gotten so political that we lose sight of it. What's going on here, maybe? Are we being warned about something? Could be. Because as I look around, I see marriages on the wane. Don't need to do that. No big problem. Sex is not even frowned upon outside of marriage. No problem. We're just having fun. We put on our documents, our constitution, one nation under God. Oh yeah? Who's God? We used to know that. That's a joke. We have politicians that do whatever they want to do. Take credit for it. I'll save you. No, they won't. God will save you. I'll fix it for you. No, God will fix it for you. and no men. Father, looks down the country that he gave us. Does he see us? Or does he see Sodom and Gomorrah? A place that's in your repute. We're told that we can cut down our CO2 emissions and we'll save the climate. Listen to a lot of scientists, we could take the United States over out of the equation and it would make no difference. We're being governed by the new Pharisees. This goes on for years and years and years. There's a lot of money in climate change. There's a lot of money in disruption. The old Pharisees, as the description goes, were the people, the Pharisees, were set apart in their own righteousness. They took themselves away from the people. They did what was best for them. Christ was not there for them. He was going to take it away from them. We send money around the world for abortions. Doesn't seem to bother anyone.
Yeah.
Not a lot of movements against it. It still happens. We put these people in office. We never asked them if they were for abortion or against it.
No.
It's something we do. And we've done it in both parties. We remove God from his prominence. We want to chip his name off the courthouse, taking other things. I'm saying prayers at schools. Don't put God there. Kids might get the wrong idea. We're in charge. Our faith is attacked. Our Christian faith is attacked. I wonder how so many of our politicians can be in office with much greater wealth than they came in with. I wonder what they're selling. How does one of our ex-presidents, Bill Clinton, co-host the empowerment of women? It's amazing how fast we forget who this man was. What he did in the Oval Office. How we forget. He's gonna host the empowerment of women. At least that jet doesn't climb to an island. It's where we put our trust. Jesus tells us against whoever's for me can't be against me. And yet we close almost everything in government with God's name. We know some of the terms. We better wake up before we get woke up. The seven deadly sins, and one of them is sloth. God hates worse than anything someone who does nothing. If you do nothing, we can't move you. Be careful with who you sleep with. Even your terrible thing, but be careful. A young woman once said, I didn't know Satan would be so handsome. Didn't know he was going to promise me everything I ever wanted. And then he destroyed me, shamed me, and led me to destruction. And our Lord tells us, you are either with me or you are against me.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten of man, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For as man for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus assured his disciples that those who remain in him can ask for whatever they want, and it would be done for them. So we have the confidence to bring our needs before the Lord.
For the church, that we may continue to blossom on the true vine, that is Jesus Christ exercising true discipleship, bearing fruit in the world, let us pray the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who live in countries or regions where they are persecuted or oppressed, who live in fear of bearing fruit, that justice and peace may blossom in the darkness, let us pray the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all living things, they return to life in the spring, budding trees, flowers, plants, fruitful vegetation, and spreading vines. They may blossom in their full glory as God created them. Let us pray the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the newly baptized this Easter season, that they may form strong and fruitful branches on the true vine. Let us pray the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are lonely or isolated, that their connection to the true vine may be sustained and strengthened, as they may know their true value in God's eyes. Let us pray the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the dead, especially our departed sisters and brothers, Jennifer and Roger Roman, Olivia and Angie, and may be with our Savior in paradise. Let us pray the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, all those intentions spoken and unspoken, let us pray for hope.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Generous God, you have nourished your people and indeed all your creation from the very beginning. Continue to nourish us and grant the prayers we make in the name of your Son, the true vine, our Lord Jesus.
Standing on the waves and on the
sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected by this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant to pray that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the immolation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of all to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim: Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate a memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we will be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and those saints who are peaceful throughout the ages, we may merit to become heirs to eternal life and embrace and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At a sacred command in the form of divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but I say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Please stand. Spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come and peacefully in my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who have endured with every mystery to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Can you all be seated?
We haven't had made announcements for a long time, but we have very important changes in our liturgy and our gathering protocols. Two days ago, Bishop Sis, the Bishop of San Angelo, made new guidelines for our celebrations starting May 8th, next week. The Mass Monday is lifted in our church. Will be lifted in our church. So you are not required to pray Mass, he says, but we highly recommend you to do it. All the ribbons in our church will be taken out, so we will not leave any empty pews between pews. There's a 3 feet social distancing requirement. But basically, we will be back to normal as we have with our celebrations and Mass. On May 23, the bishop says that the dispensation to the obligation of the Sunday Mass will expire. That means that we are, as Catholics, we are supposed to go to Mass in person on Sundays as our obligation. We will make some more announcements as we go on and to remind us of the changes that are happening and that we're going to serve. Thank you.
Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your head to prayer, God.
May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gifts of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing. Amen. May he, by whose redeeming word you have received the gifts of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. Amen. And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down with you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Let us now go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.